Good afternoon, all of you. This is Sarveshwar Reddy, working as assistant professor in SNS department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Okay, today I'll take Constitution of India subject. So, first, today's class I'll discuss what is the Constitution, features of the Constitution. Today's topics I need to cover: Constitution features, compare with other countries. Second concept, why Constitution of India is a bag of borrowing. First I'll discuss why the Constitution is a bag of borrowing. So our Constitution of India is made with other constitutions. So our founding father Dr. B.R. Ambedkar said our Constitution is made from other constitutions. So in other constitutions, what are the important things? So the main important things they borrowed from other constitutions and they made it our Indian Constitution. 1950 and 1952 the Constitution came into the force. That is the reason we are conducting Republic Day, January 26th, we are conducting Republic Day. On that day, our Constitution came into the force. So came into the force means is nothing but what? The President of India is approved our Constitution, then it came into the force. So now we will discuss why the Constitution of India is a bag of borrowing. See, suppose you can take the case. Let me discuss first from which constitutions we borrow the features. So first we can take the case British. We have British's right? British Constitution. Then after that we are taking USA Constitution. Then Irish means Ireland Constitution. Next we can take the case of Australian Constitution. Then after Australian Constitution, then again we are borrowed from Canadian Constitution. Then finally South African Constitution. So what we borrowed from Britishers. Suppose you can take the case President of India. So we borrowed the President of India. It means nothing but presidential system is we borrowed from Britishers. So at the same time, suppose you can take the case here, we have the parliamentary system. We borrowed parliamentary system is also from Britishers. Then again we can take the case one more thing here, mainly Constitution head of state. And second one, lower house is very powerful compared to upper house. So next we can take the case here, fundamental rights, like you can take the case of not a fundamental rights, we can take in rule of law. So all these things we borrowed from, mainly we borrowed from Britishers. See, suppose you can take it the case here, our parliamentary system is consisting of two houses. Two houses, lower house, upper house. Lower house, upper house. So another name of lower house and upper house. Lower house means is nothing but what? It's a Lok Sabha. Then upper house is a Rajya Sabha. So lower house is a very powerful because we have the democracy system. In the democracy system, government by the people, for the people, of the people. So whenever in the lower house, suppose in the lower house, the people who are representing by the public, we can call MPs, member of parliament, they are elected through elections. So we are casting the vote. So every Indian citizen is having a right to vote their votes. So that is the reason lower house is very powerful. So this lower house system and upper house system is also we are borrowed from British's constitution. British's constitution. And one more thing again, you can take in the case here. One more thing also we borrowed from the British government, sorry, British constitution. Rule of the law. What is this rule of the law? So privilege of the rule of the law. In front of law, everyone is an equal. Everyone is an equal. So that is privilege of rule of law. So next time we are borrowed from one more thing. That is nothing but what? Single citizenship. Single citizenship. Single citizenship. We don't have dual citizenship. So we have only one single citizenship. Suppose you can take it the case after your BTEC you went foreign country. Or on site, or you got green card, then you are working in USA. After few years, suppose you got PR permanent residency. After PR again, you apply for US citizenship. On that time, you must and should be surrender Indian citizenship. So as a Indians, we don't allow, our constitution is not allowed dual citizenship. Dual citizenship. So that is the reason we can call it as a single citizenship. So next again, you can take in the case, the next one, bicameralism. Bicameralism. What is the bicameralism? Bicameralism means is nothing but India is in a strong federal with a combination of state governments and union governments. So we have the bicameralism. If you want to pass any rule, if you want to pass any law, must and should be what? The bill is need to pass through lower house, upper house, President of India. So these many stages the bill need to pass from one place to another place, another place. So it means nothing but what? Every individual member of parliament need to vote for sanction the bill. So that is the reason there is a bicameralism is there. Bicameralism is also one of the powerful constitutional feature we brought from British government, British constitution. And next one you can take the case here, controller and auditor general. So all these things borrowed from British constitution. Controller and auditor general of India. Okay, this shortcut name is CAG. You know what is the meaning of CAG? These people will perform audit. These people will perform audit. Controller and Auditor General of India. So we can call COMP, the spelling here, pronunciation controller, but whenever you can write controller, we can write COMPTROLLER, Controller of and Auditor General of India. So what is this meaning of auditor? So in the public sector organizations, suppose recently one person came to Hyderabad, sir, not Hyderabad, he came to Telugu states, especially visit Tirupati. After that he went Amaravati to meet Mr. Vice Jagan Mohan Reddy, Mr. Subramanya Swami. He is a very known person as a member of parliament in Rajya Sabha. So he said after meeting Jagan Mohan Reddy, then he went Tirupati. Then after visit the temple, then media people is asked a question. So he want to, any requirements, any changes as required in the Tirupati temple, then immediately he said what? Whatever it may be the accounts, How the money is coming to Tirupati, I mean temple money, whatever it may be, the donations and all everything, we required auditing. There is no auditing. So immediately the news people asked, if you want to audit these accounts, to whom they need to appoint? Then immediately he said CAG. From CAG we need to audit. So CAG is very powerful. They are auditing for the public sector companies like BHEL, because every year central government, at the time of the budget, they will allocate some funds for BHEL, Hindustan Aeronautical Limited, DRDO, for all these organizations, for governmental institutions. So after end of the financial year, they need to submit the financial reports to CAG, Controller and Auditor of General. What they will do is, it is an independent body. CAG appointed by President of India, not by Prime Minister or not by Rajya Sabha or Lok Sabha. So it is an independent body. What they will do is, they will audit the records. Whether it say, is there any fraud happen and all these things. So these things are borrowed from British Constitution. So next, we will discuss USA Constitution. So from USA Constitution, what are the things we borrow from USA Constitution? So suppose you can take the case here, again, we borrowed from USA Constitution, President of India here also. So some features, President of India, okay, we borrowed some features to make President of India. So how we can appoint the President of India? What is his powers? President of India is Supreme Commander of Armed Forces. He is the Supreme Commander of Armed Forces. So we have the Armed Forces, right? Like Indian Army, their military we have, Air Force we have, Navy we have. So all these three triangle departments need to report to President of India. President of India is a Supreme Commander of Armed Forces. So next you can take the case here. The next one we borrowed from USA Constitution, preamble. We can write the capital letter PREAMBLE after the small letter. Preamble of the Constitution. What is the meaning of preamble of the Constitution? It means nothing but what? Basic structure of the Constitution. The next, again, we are borrowed from USA, mainly fundamental rights. So these things also we are borrowed from USA government, USA Constitution. So here, fundamental rights, every individual citizen, we have fundamental rights. At the same time, we have the fundamental duties also, but fundamental duties are we made our own. Okay? I mean, the founding fathers of the Constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar team. But here, fundamental rights we are borrowed from USA. Fundamental rights. Then after that, we can take it the case of Vice President. Formation of the Vice President. How we can appoint the Vice President? What is his duties? What is his duties and all these things we can go for. That is nothing but functions of Vice President. Next one, amendment of the Constitution. See, amendment of the Constitution we borrow from USA, but USA Constitution is rigid Constitution. Rigid means what? What is the meaning of rigid? Rigid means we cannot change, it's a fix. USA Constitution. But there we are borrowed from amendment process. How we can do it in an amendment? Amendment of the Constitution. And one more thing, if you take it the case of nature and functions of Supreme Court. So this is, Supreme Court means is nothing but what? It is a judiciary system. Every individual citizen is having a privilege to utilize the judiciary system. Our Indian judiciary system is very strong. Whenever if you utilize the proper, if you utilize the proper. So these are the things we are borrowed from USA. Next I will discuss one small thing here from Irish. From Irish. So from Irish, we borrowed from Irish like elections of President of India. Elections of President of India. Next one, DPSP. This is very, very important. What is the meaning of DPSP? Directive, Principles of State Policy. Directive, Principles of State Policy. So here, and one more thing, we can take the case from Irish government. Here, members nomination of Rajya Sabha. Members nomination of Rajya Sabha. So these are the things we are borrowed from different constitutions. So I think you are understand everything where we borrowed features, main important features from other constitutions. Okay, thanks one and all. Thank you very much.